life.
Okay, guys, we've actually had some good activity happening on Twitter. You can actually follow our Twitter stream and put your questions up by using the hashtag GetVoIP. We've just had a user ask us a question right now. A guy called Flowroot Jeff has asked, when would you choose hosted VoIP over SIP trunking?
And the first thing I will say is, okay, Eric, explain SIP trunking in layman's terms.
No problem. SIP trunking is essentially dial tone. It's long distance or minutes. That's it. You're with a SIP trunking, you're not getting any features. You're not getting any sort of business class features like a virtual receptionist or voicemail. Someone who's providing SIP trunking is literally like an AT&T or a Verizon. Instead of using a copper line, which is, you know, traditional for the last 100 years, they're using a fiber line and some kind of internet type of signal. So that's SIP. And the thing about it, and I'll get into this, so let's just define that first. Hosted means that usually the person is going to provide not only the dial tone, the calling plan, but also features to go along with that. It's a complete package. So before we move on, what do you think about those two definitions?
I think you're head on, right? I mean, SIP is definitely less, I would say less offerings. As you mentioned, it's just dial tone, long distance. You can definitely use it in many different ways. You know, I mean, maybe Michael can share some thoughts on that. I'm not sure.
Like you said, with SIP, it's just kind of for, if you're looking for just a calling planner, I think it's well suited for residential users who, you know, are just looking to find a VoIP solution that's cheaper than the traditional service, but aren't looking for all the features and function of like a hosted solution.
Yep.
Right. So yeah, definitely the hosted packages, the hosted services are definitely far more advanced, much more extensive offerings, I should say. I mean, it depends. Again, provider to provider, it just varies all across the board, right, Eric?
And you know, I know I talk a lot with my hands. I kind of feel like that that episode of 30 Rock where the guy's got like two cups and he's like, what do I do with my hands? But I really think it's not even apples and oranges. It's apples and cars. I mean, they're really, really different. So here's what I see typically. In my experience, I feel that hosted tends to be a better fit for most small and mid-sized businesses. So here are some advantages of hosted and some advantages of SIP. Hosted is nice because it's a complete package. It's a one-stop shop. That's always nice, especially if you're a smaller business, you don't have an IT staff. It can be very valuable to have that outsourced. Of course, you want to look at their quality of their support, but that's a conversation. The other nice thing about hosted is it's very, very good at working with remote offices, or if you just want to be able to work from home very easily. You know, not disasters, but your kids get sick, your car tire pops, excuse me, and you want to work from home. Hosted providers are very, very good at working with all kinds of internet. In addition to that, there's always the feature sets that are there. I also think a good hosted provider has disaster recovery in mind, because if you lose local power or local internet, their cloud should still be in the cloud, right? It's just your office. So again, you know, when I look at hosted, some of the things that I really target are, you know, 1 to 1,000 employees. I mean, even 1 to 5,000, but we'll get to that. 1 to, you know, a couple thousand employees. Multiple offices, especially when you start getting 1,000 employees, 2,000 employees, that's when the hosted play becomes really powerful. And as because of the distributed workforce and stuff like that. And then anyone who wants to just kind of outsource the IT. SIP, on the other hand, I see two really good targets for that. One, you're tech savvy, and you not only are you tech savvy, but you just enjoy playing with technology, and you know, you want to set it up yourself, you want to manage it yourself, you don't mind if it has problems, and you want to be the one that fixes it. There's a lot of people like that, and if that's you, that might be an option. The other way that I see SIP very frequently is in very, very large companies, 5,000 and above, or 1,000 and above in a single location, and they don't have to deal with a distributed workforce. They just want a big pipe coming in, and they want to manage everything internally.